So these were basic definitions, and now we study some techniques to determine the stability. The idea was simple. If along the trajectories are states of the system as a function of time, if along the trajectories, if energy of the system is decreasing, that will finally converge to the equilibrium point. For example, you have pendulum, simple pendulum, and here at this point it has lowest energy, right? It will oscillate about this equilibrium point, and if there is also friction, then during this motion it will lose its energy and will finally converge to the equilibrium point. If there is no friction, then it will continue on oscillating. So if along the trajectories, if a system loses its energy, then that equilibrium point is stable equilibrium point. In pendulum with friction, and we know that it has two equilibrium points, 0, 0, and the second equilibrium point is 0, pi 0. And energy E of X, energy, total energy of this pendulum is the sum of potential energy and kinetic energy. Kinetic energy, the potential energy is, if there is no friction, then what will be rate of change of energy? The pendulum is oscillating and there is no friction. So what will be rate of change of energy?
Zero.
Zero along the trajectories. So if this is the case, then what it means intuitively?
Stable.
It will keep on oscillating about this equilibrium point. That is, it is not, it is simply stable, it is not asymptotically stable. However, if its energy is decreasing, that is dE by dt is less than zero, then what will be the case? It will finally converge to the equilibrium point. That is, the equilibrium point is asymptotically stable. Exponential stability अभी हम conclude नहीं कर सकते हैं. Asymptotic stability, हमें ये पता है कि energy ये lose कर रहा है और आहिस्ता आहिस्ता इसकी energy कम होती जा रही है और ultimately ये energy zero हो जाएगी. तो that is, it is asymptotically stable. Exponential stability अभी यहाँ से हम conclude नहीं कर सकते हैं. So Leonov described that generally finding energy of a system is not an easy task, specifically or when the states of the system are not real physical variables, then finding this energy is difficult, right? So what we can do? So he mentioned that any positive definite function can be taken as energy function. Here is Lyapunov's theorem, which states that let x equal to 0 be an equilibrium point. For our system, that is x dot is equal to f of x. We remember that if equilibrium point is not at origin, we can use state transformations to bring the equilibrium point to at origin. So this does not cause any loss of generality. Furthermore, let v of x be a function which maps the domain of interest into set of real numbers. What is domain of interest? Again, we may not be interested in the entire state space. Rather, we may only be interested in some subset of the sphere space, that subset is called domain. Right? Domain, region, whatever you call it. This is domain in which we are interested. Right? Sometimes we are interested in the entire state space. So in that case, that will be Rn. Nth dimensional space. So this domain is subset of this nth dimensional space. So this function maps this domain into set of real numbers, right? And furthermore, this function is continuously differentiable. We can find the derivative of this function. Derivative exists, right? Furthermore, v of 0 is equal to 0. That is, if we substitute x equal to 0 into this function, that will be equal to 0. And for x which are not equal to 0, let me write it in easier way. For x not equal to 0. If x is not equal to 0, and then this function is greater than 0, v of x is greater than 0. Additionally, if we find the derivative of that function along the trajectories of system and it comes out to be negative definite, then the equilibrium point will be stable. Right? This function, which satisfies these two properties, is called positive definite function. Function which satisfies these two properties, that this is equal to 0 for x equal to 0 and this is greater than 0 for x not equal to 0, this function is called positive definite function. This function, what is v of 0? V of 0, that is if we substitute x equal to 0, so a into 1 minus cosine of 0 is 1 plus 1 into 0 square. So v of 0 is equal to 0. Furthermore, for x not equal to 0, for x not equal to 0, if x is not equal to 0, then what will be this expression? So this will always be positive, right? This term is always positive. This cosine of x1 cannot exceed 1. So this term is also positive. It means that this function will remain positive for all values of x not equal to 0. So that is, this function is positive definite function. It satisfies these two conditions. So we have selected appropriate positive definite function. Positive definiteness ki baat clear ho gayi hai. What about, for example, this function? V of x is equal to x1 square plus x2 square for x belonging to two dimensional space. Is it positive definite function or not?
Yes.
For x equal to 0, this function is 0. For x not equal to 0, it is always positive. What about this function? Is it positive definite?
Yes, sir.
It is not positive definite because for x1 equal to x2 and d is not equal to 0, this function is still 0. So this is not positive definite. So it must be greater than 0 for x not equal to 0. This is not positive definite. Still, for another example, for the same two-dimensional space, what about this function? We have two-dimensional space. What about this function? Is it positive definite or not?
Yes.
Yes.
Can you tell me any non-zero x? X is this one. Any non-zero x, which makes this equal to zero.
X1 अगर 0 ले लें, X2 कोई भी हो.
Yes. 0 and X2 anything. So what does it mean? This is not positive definite. So we cannot take this function as we call it candidate Lyapunov function. We cannot take it as candidate Lyapunov function. For candidate Lyapunov function, it must be positive definite, that is, it must satisfy these two conditions. So we have taken this candidate Lyapunov function for this particular example. We take its derivative, v dot of x. This dot is derivative of x with respect to t, which is equal to its derivative with respect to x1. What is that? What is derivative of cosine of x
minus.
With respect to x is
minus,
and minus cancels out. Minus is sine of x1 into the derivative of x1 with respect to time.
Yes,
and likewise, its derivative with respect to x2, and then derivative of x2 with respect to time. That is, this dot is derivative with respect to time. And then we simply substitute here x1 dot is x2, so x2. So we have computed the derivative of this candidate Lyapunov function along system trajectories, and we came up with this result. What about this v dot? It is either less than 0 or equal to 0. Equal to 0 for any value of x1, and x2 equal to 0. So it is less than or equal to 0. It cannot be greater than 0. You cannot tell any value. So what is conclusion? Then the equilibrium point which was at origin for this system is stable. What we conclude is that equilibrium point is stable. What about asymptotic stability? क्या ये negative definite है ये function? ये वाला function? ये negative semi-definite है. ये कुछ x की values के लिए. For example, this was non-zero x. It is still zero. So it is negative semi-definite. So the conclusion is that the equilibrium point is stable. Remember that these conditions are only sufficient conditions and not necessary conditions. What do we mean by that? We can conclude from here that equilibrium point is stable. However, we cannot conclude that equilibrium point is not asymptotically stable. The implication is only one directional. That is, if this is satisfied, then equilibrium point is stable. If this is satisfied, then equilibrium point is asymptotically stable. If this is not satisfied, we cannot say that equilibrium point is not asymptotically stable, right? Clear? For example, for this system, we know that the equilibrium point is asymptotically stable. However, what Lyapunov theory has told us that this is only stable, right? We were not sure whether equilibrium point is asymptotically stable or not. For that purpose, we can somehow modify Lyapunov function to reach at the asymptotic stability, which we shall talk about in the next lecture, inshallah. Any question up to this point?
Sir, equilibrium point tha, wo other than 0 hota
hai. Hum use transform karte hain 0 pe. Isi system ke liye hume pata hai ki do equilibrium points hain. To hum abhi jis equilibrium point ki baat kar rahe hain, wo ye wala equilibrium point hai, 0, 0. Aur dusre equilibrium point ki agar aapne baat karni hai, to you will be required to transform this equilibrium point to origin. We know how we can do that. For example, we can define a new state variable z1 equal to x1 minus pi. That will simply transform that equilibrium point to origin, and then we apply all this theory.
Haan,
how to find the candidate Lyapunov function? That is the only difficulty, and we shall study some guidelines which will help us to select a candidate Lyapunov function.